Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this and the following five episodes, I'll walk you through an enormous amount of pain I had in creating designer plugins from the special widgets that I have in KDAB. In this first episode, I'll show you the starting point. I'll show you how I had promoted widgets, and I'll explain to you what promoted widgets are, and I'll especially highlight the disadvantages of using promoted widgets. In the next episode, I will do another amount of preparation. I'll namely discuss how do you initialize your widgets that are promoted. The problem is that you don't have a constructor because widgets that are dragged in Qt Designer cannot have anything but a default constructor. Well, a constructor taking a Qt widget pointer parent. The next step is to make a library out of your application, because you are very likely not able to take your widgets and compile them standalone. You'll want to have them as part of your running application. So we'll have to make another knee bend before we can get started, namely create a library out of your widget. Then the following two episodes, I will actually create the plugins. The first one, I'll create the plugins, and then the following one, I will discuss how do you actually deploy that plugin, where should files be copied, and I'll show you a lot of CMake magic to make that happen. And the final episode, I will show you some of the pain that I went through. I namely couldn't figure out why my plugin didn't load. So in the end, I had to dig up some Windows tools or some Linux tools. I'll show you both, and hopefully that will teach you to fish, not only serve you the fish. So at the end of this mini-series, I'll provide you with a complete example of this, including CMake files for setting it all up. The example that we start out with is a very simple file view. So I'm sure that you have at least one of those in your code base. It's a line edit and a push button or a tool button with three dots on. And when you click that tool button, it will show up a file chooser. Actually, we already saw that particular component previously. So you are looking at that component now. It's a Qt widget. It's a file selector here, and it has a few properties. We'll get back to those in a bit. It has a constructor that just takes a Qt widget pointer parent. So far, so good. I would like to use that in an image viewer. And the way that it works with promotion of widgets is that I'll find the widget that is the closest to, and this situation is just a pure Qt widget. I'll drag that into my layout. I will give it a name, file chooser, and I will promote it. And see, I have a terrible memory. It's called file selector. So better call it the right thing. Also spell it correct, file selector. And what I need to do in using this as a plugin with just promotion is that I need to right click on it. I need to go down and say promote to and promote the class name. That was file selector. And where is the header file? It's all of it is in the same directory, but I could have subdirectories here. And do I want quotes or do I want angle brackets? If I want angles, a global include, then I'll check this one. I'll add and promote. And this being Qt creator, I can go to tools. I can never remember where it is. So I'm stalling time here. Tools, form layout, and preview. And this is what it looks like in a preview. This is the real widgets that has been instantiated. Here's a real Qt label that's been instantiated here. And up here, well, it's promotion, so it doesn't know how to actually show it. In any case, let's try and run the application. And hoping that I actually spelled it the same as I did before, I did, it seems. Here you can see that now I can actually bring up a file selector here. I can go somewhere on my hard disk. I'll not bother you with that. And I could have loaded in an image that would be shown down there. One thing to observe, though, was when I brought this up, you could see that it down here said save. that's not all I want. I want to load. I want to load an image, not to save an image. And why did it say save? Well, let's go and look at our file selector here. It has a mode, and the mode is specified down here, either file open, file save, or directory. And depending on that mode, whenever I bring up my file chooser, it will, depending on the mode, it will bring up get open file name, get save file name, get existing. And we can also see down here that the default mode is file save. So I have to go to my image viewer over here. And in my constructor, I need to say UI pointer, what was it called? File selector dot set mode. And the mode was file selector mode file open. And now when I run my application, it actually shows me a loading dialog here instead of, you see it says open here rather than save. So isn't this good enough for your daily use? I mean, it isn't rocket science to know that this empty blank area up there actually is a file chooser. Well, it might be good enough, but there's at least three shortcomings in this approach. First, you can't see the widget. Maybe that's not a big deal for you. Maybe it is. Maybe you have some real-world designers, not like Qt designer, but real-world designers that cannot cope with the fact that they cannot see that widget in action. Second, that property for the file load and file save, whatever, that mode property, I would have liked to specify that from within Qt designer. And thirdly, how do I even know that it's okay to promote just a regular Qt widget to this particular one? Well, I do know it if I have a handbook that says so. And fourth, hey, that's even more than three. I said at least three. Fourth, figuring out which component I have at all can I rather be difficult. Let me go back to Qt Designer just a second to show you what I mean. So here, back in my Qt Designer, let me find the UI file. It is here. If you look, if I make Qt go away, if you scroll down here, you can see all of these, that they are from KDAB viewer. I have a team combo box and a team selector. What's the difference between the two? Well, this is a team combo box and this is a team selector. That's super easy to know when you can just drag them in. So the user of those components much easier can work with them. Let me just give you one trick. Should you choose to do a promotion instead of the plugins? And there are reasons why you would not want the plugins. First of all, it took me almost 3 or 4 days to get them working because I just had endless amount of trouble with them. But the second reason why you might want the plugins, if you want not to use the plugins and you use the promoted widget, what I suggest is that you create one widget with all of your promoted, and I'll show you why. Let me create a new file here. It's a Qt, I just want a regular Qt widget. Where are you? Qt, I'm confused. Qt Designer form class, of course. That's what I was looking for. And now, if I in here, yeah, carry on, nothing to see. And if I now take a new widget, oh, come on. There we are. I take that in. And if I promote that one now, you can see that it already have the file selector. And that's because that I had it from another file. So if you have a gallery.ui file with all your promoted widget, you just load that file in, and then they are all available for promote to. Okay, that's it for this initial episode. Sorry for stumbling over my words and not bothering re-recording that bit. I'll blame it on Corona as we do here in 2021. In the next episode that I'll send out real soon now, we'll discuss how do we actually initialize our widget? Should we want to go down with, well, even if we just want them as promotion, we still cannot run a constructor that is anything but QWidget pointer parent. So how do you actually initialize them? You have setters, but when can you run code that rely on those setters? That's what we'll be discussing in next episode. Until then, stay safe. And don't forget to leave your comments in the section below.